Hello there, folks. How are you? It's lovely to see you again as usual, and a very warm welcome back to What's For Tea. Like I said, it is lovely to see you, and I do appreciate you popping over just to have a nosy at what I picked up for the family food shop this week. So by request, we have gone to Morrison's. I know a few of you have asked us to pop in there just to see, you know, what. So we have gone to Morrison's for a click and collect, and it was great. You know, just as usual, you do your order online and you go and pick up and you stick it in the back of your car and away you go. And it could not have been easier, just exactly the same as it works with Tesco or Sainsbury's or any of the others. If you're new here, my name's Cheryl. Like I said, this is What's For Tea. And if you do like these kinds of videos, why not consider subscribing just before you leave? We are a family of four from the west coast of Scotland, and it'd be lovely to see you back again. So this is just our shopping for the week ahead. I've also got a few things to get from the local butcher, and I picked up a wee pie from the local farm shop as well, which is actually within our local garden centre, but their pies are absolutely fabulous. So this is everything that I got here, and I spent just over £70, and I feel as though I got an awful lot there for the money, because there are four or five dinners here that I can make up from this. So that's just a wee quick look at the receipt there. So £73.71p. So as usual, I got our grated cheese. So I got mozzarella and cheddar mix. That's lovely for in a cheese sauce on top of a pasta. It's got a lovely melty quality to it, and also the red Leicester, which is good for anything really. And then a wee pot of sour cream, because we're going to be having chicken fajitas during the week. Yeah, chicken fajitas, you did hear me right. We're going daft and we're trying something new. So that's what the sour cream is for. And then Mr. What's For Tea's fruit cocktail trifles. He's been liking these over the past few weeks, so I picked them up for him. And it is just jelly and custard and sponge and cream. A big cauliflower. I'll end up turning this into cauliflower cheese, no doubt. And then a swede, because this goes at the side of most of the things that I make. A net of onions, because I'm just about out of them. And then some blueberries. These are nice for on top of cereal or yogurt, or even just for snacking on, and they are really good for you, apparently. And then some butter, but I've got some butter still there. And then some more cheese. This one I've got to grate myself, but this one is actually a really good price, so I picked that one up as well. A big bag of our usual potatoes. I haven't been doing many mashed potatoes, roast potatoes, but it is getting a bit cooler now, so we're back into the roast potato weather. Although in saying that, it's really warm today. And then some munch too, and then a couple of bags of iceberg lettuce. We like to put this into a salad or even a sandwich. And here's the fajita kit. So this is the one that I got. There are loads of different ones you can get, but I got the cool one because I'm the only one in the house that likes things extra spicy. So as I haven't had this before, I thought I'd err on the side of caution and get the cool one. That way we'll all enjoy it. And apparently this will serve four, and just add your own chicken and things. So yeah, excited to try that. And then some tomatoes. These are the extra large, fine ripened, which are full of flavour. And then some tender stem broccoli. And then some lemons. I like to put lemons into water or with fish and chips or something. A couple of iced buns for Mr. What's For Tea. And these wee chicken fillets I will use in the chicken fajitas. And I'm also going to be doing some wee chicken pies as well. Some pork sausage rolls. I saw these and I thought, oh, we might as well pick them up because they're as cheap as chips. And if we don't have them for a lunch, we'll have them for a dinner. This wee Wagamama katsu curry kit I seen and looked quite interesting. This will do me and Mr. What's For Tea one night, because I reckon it's going to be quite mild. And I've heard that Wagamama's katsu curry is quite famous, although I usually do my own. For some fish and chips, I picked up some mushy peas. So I got the original and also the chip shop, just to see what the difference is, if any. There might not be any difference, but I thought I'd get one of each just to see. Some no sugar fizzy juice or fizzy water. This is the raspberry and blackberry one, 35p. And then a couple of packs of sugar jelly, zero sugar jelly crystals. And then some basmati rice to add to the katsu curry kit. I've got some rice there, but I did need an extra one. This is just the sort of piercing ding one. a couple of packs of savoury rice. I like to have these kinds of things in the cupboard just for a quick lunch or something, the same as these pasta and sauce sachets. Mr. Whatsfortea actually likes these just as a quick snack or lunch. And then a big bag of our usual macaroni. And then to go with the chicken fajitas, I thought I'd pop a few of these tortilla chips just at the side because I've seen that done in other people's meals of the week. We're going to be doing a fish pie, so I thought this looked quite easy to use instead of buying fresh fish and sort of chopping it all up. This is already done, and if we don't have it this week, we can have it next week and it'll just sit in the freezer quite happy. Some quavers instead of our usual watsits, some wee bin liners for the food caddy, and then some bourbon creams. I haven't had these for years. And then that's the wee pie from Dalduff Farm Shop, which is actually within our local garden centre. And they do all sorts of wonderful pies. But this one is just mince and onion. And it's just exactly the same as the one that I do, but it's done for you. For the freezer, I got a bag of quorn. This is a kind of mince substitute. Some Kit Kat ice cream lolly bar stick things. Those are 50p off those. And these lighter chips, we all really enjoy. And you wouldn't tell, you know, that they're lighter. For me, for the odd lunch, I just like to have this kind of thing in the freezer. They're only a pound and they're so low calorie. I mean, 291 calories for a spaghetti bolognese is crazy. And the lasagna is 266. I mean, it never looks like they do on the box, do they? But for a quick lunch, you know, for a pound, I don't think you can really go wrong, even if they're not the best. They'll fill a hole. Then some fish fingers. These weren't the ones that I'd ordered. I'd ordered the gastro ones, you know, the kind of posh fish fingers for some posh fish finger sandwiches, but they didn't have them. A bag of Jasper's cat litter, a couple of bags of treats for him, and then some floor cleaner as well. Actually, talking about Jasper, I'm actually feeling a bit sad as I'm doing this and not my usual kind of upbeat self, or I'm trying to be. He actually went missing this morning. We keep the window, as you know, he is an inside cat, but we keep the windows open. They're quite high up though. They're what we call hopper windows, so they are quite high. Just before I move on, sorry, and talk about that, I wanted to say a massive thank you, as usual, to the supporters of the channel over my Patreon page and to the channel members here on YouTube as well. So thank you for your ongoing support. And there he is there. So yeah, we've got these quite high up windows. They're called hopper windows, and we've got a kind of sideboard that just sits underneath, and we got up this morning and went to feed him as usual, and he's usually sitting there, you know, waiting on you in the morning, and he wasn't there. To cut a long story short, he has actually got out because of our fur around the window, the wee hopper window, so he has actually squeezed out of there during the night, and we've been out to try and look for him, and obviously we just can't find him, so we're just keeping our fingers crossed that he does come back. We've taken advice and we've done the usual, you know, putting his cat litter tray at the back step and put some treats out. We've put something on the washing line with our scent on it, and hopefully he picks it up. But yeah, I will let you know what happens with that. So yeah, we're a bit sad at the moment, but yeah, just trying to keep positive and hoping for the best. So thank you all for watching, guys, if you're still here at this point, and I will catch you off soon back here on What's for Tea. Take care and bye for now. Bye now.